A year or so ago, I made the M9 rubber band gun. It's a free set of plans on the internet, and there's a lot of parts and pieces that you have to cut out, glue together, and finish. Someone has taken all of those parts and created sub-assemblies so you can print the same thing on the 3D printer. I'm printing the right side frame. Later I'll print the left side. Then there'll be the left and right grips. Go back here and the internal pieces. Then we'll put it together and see how well it works. For a rubber band gun, these are surprisingly accurate. Printing a gun on a 3D printer. A safe rubber band gun. Safe if you don't shoot anybody in the eye with it. Zigzag support material ends up being about 5/8 of an inch high and supports the internal compartment of the pistol. And this is laying in the crosshatch infill in these areas. This is the left frame of the pistol and ends up being about 13/16 of an inch thick. Bed temperature right now is set to be 50. This is Creelty's Ultra Base. It's a piece of glass with an adhesive layer on the back side, and you glue it onto the heated bed, and you'll peel a layer off that reveals this surface, which when you clean it with denatured alcohol has a little sticky feel to it. The PLA sticks to it pretty well. I did have a few issues with a print that's on the bed for a long time like this one. I was getting a little bit of warping on a few corners. So I was experimenting with a brim. I was running the bed at 60 degrees centigrade. My initial layer for the PLA was at 210, and then the remaining layers were at 200 degrees centigrade. This is at room temperature now, and it's supposed to release the part. We'll see. Need a little encouragement. Right. On there pretty tight. Very smooth. This is the magazine for the rubber band gun. I printed this one last night. Filament temperature 200 degrees, bed temperature 60. Came out really nice. I tried this one this morning and lowered the bed temperature to 50 degrees and it separated and it started to warp really bad in through here. And the brim had completely parted company with the bed surface back in this area. Canceled that one, printed this one, 60 degree bed temperature, 200 degree filament temperature, 210 on the first layer. This is back to room temperature. Let's see if it comes off of there. Comes right off. So the smaller items, they come off of this pretty well. I see no indication of any warping on this at all. This turned out real well. When we download a file from Thingiverse and go to print it, we don't really know how that's going to turn out until after we get through printing it. Not everything on Thingiverse is exactly correct. And that's the case with this rubber band gun. It's close, but you're going to have to fiddle with it a little bit. When we take this apart, there's quite a few pieces that you need to print. What I call the hammer sear is printed in a left and a right, and you have to put it together and glue it. The trigger is printed in a left and a right and needs to be assembled, glued. And what I call this trigger bar connects the trigger and the hammer sear. And when you print this the first time, it will be this piece. And I printed this without the pins. I'm using 5/32 piano wire in all of these positions because it works very smoothly. And this is designed to have some plastic pins on it. You can print that without the pins by taking this side and lowering it through the build plate in Cura until the pins go through the top surface, and this part is laying dead flat on the build surface. Then as you print it, you stop the print just as it starts to print the pins, and then you know where to drill the holes. Except if you use that, it moves this pin about 2 millimeters too far in this direction, and this trigger hammer sear assembly will not function correctly. I make this 100% infill because I'm going to be drilling holes through here, and I made the spacing center to center on these holes 29 millimeter. There's another problem. When you print the hammer sear, it will not fit in that cavity. It's too thick. So you're going to have to reduce the thickness of this part and this part. And when you reduce the thickness for these two pieces, you'll find out you need to reduce the thickness for what I call the trigger bar. Another issue with both the hammer sear and the trigger, you're given a left and a right piece. And when I put those together, I found out that they weren't parallel to each other. The top face or whatever sometimes was a little bit off, and one of these was a different thickness than the other, either on the sear or on the trigger, or I forget which. So the way that I fixed that, I took one part, I duplicated it, and then I mirrored it, which gave me this piece. And then I knew I had two parts that were truly identical. Then when I assembled it, put the pins through here to align it, it glued together, and the alignment and everything on the surfaces was perfect. And I did the same thing with the trigger. Take one part, duplicate it, mirror it, and then it'll go together, and it assembled quite nicely. And I had to reduce the Z thickness on these parts, and I will give the dimension that I used for my pistol. It'll be down in the description. We're not quite done with the issues. The hammer just barely touches this part of the sear, but it does touch. When you pull the trigger and then the hammer wants to rotate, this part of the sear stops the hammer. And as this is configured, this does not allow the hammer to rotate enough for the rubber bands to come off. In Cura, I increased the X and Y dimension a little over 11%. I left Z alone. It made these pieces of the hammer stick out a little bit longer. And then I ground this surface, ground it back here until that flat was inside this hole. I ended up with this. It allows that to rotate more, and the rubber bands will come off of there. And then you want to round over these corners and make everything as smooth as possible so it doesn't tear up the rubber bands. The reason this is having an issue with releasing the rubber bands is the orientation of this point is not exactly the same as the original M9 rubber band gun. When I built this from the original plans, there's really no dimensions given. It's a set of patterns, and you take the patterns and glue it onto the wood and you cut it out. Pattern shows where to drill the holes. You match drill the left and right frames. You put it together and it works perfect. The easiest way to explain the differences is to take this right frame and set it on top of this one. And we can see that this pistol is a lot smaller than this one. And then they tried to use the existing mechanism internally to make it work. And they didn't quite get the location of some of these pins in the right position. I didn't know all of these issues, and I had to find out for myself, but now you do know about them, and you should not have any difficulty making the parts for this pistol. And this rubber band gun works very well. When you get everything in here and it's moving nicely, everything's all polished up, sometimes this will work just by pulling the trigger. If you limit this to 6 rubber bands, cocking the hammer for each one, you can put the 7th one on here. If you try to put more than that on here, sometimes the rubber bands will get wedged between the spacer and the frame. When you start looking at the files on the download from Thingiverse, generally what you're going to get for the left and right hand frame is the grip will be part of the frame. I asked the guy that did the remix, and the thing that's listed in my description, if this is not in the file, then if you go down to comments, the files for this and this as separate pieces are available there. And you're able to print a pistol that's got nice contrast to it. This is a very realistic looking pistol. May not be advisable to have kids run around neighborhood waving these things around. This looks very authentic. Manufacturers, I believe, are supposed to make the end of the pistol orange to identify it as a toy gun. You might want to paint this or print something in orange that will go over the end of this so it doesn't look quite so real. It'd be kind of silly to get shot over a rubber band gun.